नमस्ते। श्वास क्रिया इज एन इम्पॉर्टेंट फिजियोलॉजिकल प्रोसेस नेसेसरी फॉर द एक्सिस्टेंस ऑफ लाइफ। इन आयुर्वेदा द फंक्शंस ऑफ वाता आर हेल्ड रेस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर द प्रोसेस ऑफ रेस्पिरेशन इन द ह्यूमन बॉडी। इन दिस वीडियो वी विल ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड द प्रोसेस ऑफ रेस्पिरेशन अकॉर्डिंग टू आयुर्वेदा अलॉन्ग विद सम इनपुट्स फ्रॉम सिद्धा, योगा एंड ट्रेडिशनल चाइनीज मेडिसिन। वी विल ऑल्सो इंक्लूड parts of contemporary physiology of respiration where and when required. In Doshadi Vijnaniyam chapter of Ashtanga Hridaya, the following has been mentioned as the Prakrita Karma of Vata Dosha. Tamchala Utsahochvasa Nishvasa Cheshta Vega Pravartanehi Samyaghatya Cha Dhatunam Akshanam Pathavena Cha Anugrihnyati Avikrutaha. We are going to focus on two of the functions of Vata Dosha in this video. Uchvasa is Urdha Shvasanam, Shvasa Mukti, and Nishvasa is Shvasasya Sharira Antapraveshanam, according to Acharya Arunadatta. Acharya Hemadri has also given similar explanations for these terms, Shvasa Nirgama and Shvasa Pravesha. Hence, we can conclude that non-vitiated vata is responsible for exhalation and inhalation in the body. Vata dosha on the basis of functions has been classified into 5 types in Ayurveda. They are prana, udana, samana, vyana and apana. Among these, prana and udana are most influential for respiration. The explanation of pranavata goes as follows. Prano atra murdaga urakkanta charo buddhi hrudayendriya cittadhruk shtivanakshavatodghara nishwasana praveshakrut. This can be understood as a collection of autonomic functions which include thought process, sensory perception, hunger, respiration, deglutition, etc. Udanavata is explained as उरस्तानमुदानस्य नासानाभिगलांश्चरेत् वाक्प्रवृत्तिप्रयत्नोर्जा बलवर्णस्मृतिक्रिया। This is related to the act of respiration because of its site of action and also owing to the fact that it nourishes the body to perform other major functions. In Vimanasthana of Charaka Samhita, in the context of Srotas, the Moola of Pranavaha Srotas has been mentioned as follows. Pranavahanam srotasam hridayam moolam mahasrotascha. Here, the srotas wherein prana is processed, transformed and circulated throughout the body is called pranavaha srotas. And its core sites are hridaya and mahasrotas. We can understand that this is a bridge between external, internal and cellular respiration as per contemporary physiology of respiration. With this background, let us move on to the explanation of respiration by Acharya Sharangdara. Acharya Sharangdara has explained in Purvakhanda the physiological process of abnormal breathing as the total process of normal breathing and the transport of atmospheric energy elements to the organs, to the tissue and the cells. Nabhistha pranapavana sprishtva hrutkamalantaram कंटाद् बहिर्विनिर्याति पातुं विष्णुपदामृतं पीत्वा चाम्बर पीयूषं पुनरायति वेगता प्रीणयन् देहमखिलं जीवयन् जटरानलम्। द प्राण लोकेटेड इन द नाभि इज एक्सपेल्ड आउट ऑफ द कंटा और द थ्रोट वाया द हृत्कमला विच रिप्रेजेंट्स द कार्डियोपल्मोनरी सिस्टम। दिस प्राण गेट्स इनटू कॉन्टैक्ट विद द एनवायरमेंटल वायु। हियर it gets fused with the atmospheric energy elements and rapidly surges back into the sharira. Inside the body, this prana nourishes the whole body and maintains the agni present in the abdomen. Let us elaborate this explanation. The process of respiration has been told to start from the nabhi, where the prana is expelled out. Why is this process of expiration mentioned first? In Siddha, there are two aspects to breathing, Shvasa and Nishvasa. Nishwasa is the gross breathing, which includes inhalation and exhalation carried out by the lungs to draw in oxygen and supply to the body tissues. But how is it different from Shwasa according to Siddha? For Nishwasa to take place, there has to be a subsource of energy which is extracted by the chakras for everyone every day in the Dantian. Shwasa is the inner breath which deals with the energy exchange between the body and the universe. This is the subtler aspect of all the grosser functions that we observe in the body. Dantian is a storehouse of energy according to traditional Chinese medicine. This concept evolved from the ancient Taoist and Buddhist practices. This represents a universal matrix of energy which executes all the functions of the body of all the organisms. They are believed to hold the three treasures of the body known as Jing, Qi, Shen. These are thought to be the subtle energies that support and sustain the blood, bodily fluids, and solid tissues. They are believed to support the development of the physical body as well as the development of the mind and the soul on the path of consciousness. Chakra is different from Dantian by the fact that chakras are gateways through which this universal energy can be accessed. In Acharya Sharangdara's verse, he describes everything in reverse for that very reason. Respiration doesn't begin with inhalation, but with the energy generated at the nabi that then triggers the cardiopulmonary function. Pranapavana doesn't refer to pranavata as such, but prana, electric energy. Here, pavana does not represent the gross vayu. It is a synonym of Lord Hanuman. From this perspective, pavana represents the electromagnetic energy which stimulates the respiratory pathway. Does this all connect? When this entire pathway is triggered, only then does the inhalation of Ambara Piyusha occur, which then initiates the next vega of respiration by igniting the Agni of the Nabi. Ambara Piyusha, which can be understood as Akasha Amrita, represents not just oxygen but the entire mixture of gases and energy elements that cause physical nourishment and energization. To add on, let us look into a few more references. The above verses establish the last line of Acharya Sharangdara Sloka. They explain how the prana, enriched with the atmospheric energy elements, circulates throughout the body to nourish and enliven the body and perform various functions. To understand this better, let us look into an excerpt from an article whose link will be mentioned in the description box below. Now the whole process explained by Acharya Sharangdara, added on with the concepts from Siddha and traditional Chinese medicine, makes sense, right? Also, do you now realize why Acharya Vagbhata mentioned Uchvasa first before Nishvasa? Further, we will now look into Pranayama, which is the application level exercise of the physiology of respiration. This is the fourth one among the Ashtanga Yoga and deals with the control of breath. Apart from inhalation and exhalation, other dimensions of breathing are also explained in pranayama. Let us see what they are. Puraka, Kumbhaka, Rechaka, and Shunyaka. Several variants of pranayama are present, which utilizes the permutations and combinations of these four dimensions as per the requirement. Apart from its health benefits, pranayama helps in elevating the practitioner to a higher state of existence by reducing the energy eliminated per shwasa, which we described earlier. In several Eastern practices like Tai Chi and Reiki, Dantian breathing and meditation hold significance. We previously looked into the basics of what Dantian is. Dantian breathing is similar to pranayama. It's an intentional practice that focuses on controlling the breath, which is believed to contain subtle life force within it. In Western terms, it's considered diaphragmatic breathing, wherein the belly expands outwards upon each inhalation and then contracts inwards and upwards with each exhalation. Before we conclude, let us revise what we learned in this video. We understood the importance of Vata Dosha in the physiology of respiration and also looked into how Pranavata and Udanavata are significant. We further looked into Pranavaha Srotas and how it is a site of process, transformation and circulation of prana in the body. Further, we learned the complete physiology of respiration according to Ayurveda as per Acharya Sharangdhara and also understood its inner meaning by taking references from Siddha and Dantian. We also tried to affirm it using references from contemporary physiology. Later, we went through the basics of pranayama and Dantian breathing. We will leave links for more information regarding pranayama, Dantian, the Siddha concepts of respiration, and other articles regarding respiration according to Ayurveda in the description box. If you are interested to learn about this, do refer them. Thank you for your patience. If you like this video, hit the like button and comment with your opinions. Consider subscribing to our channel and follow us on Instagram and Facebook.